So, welcome to my class today, dear students. And here, I am going to discuss an important concept on the radical. Are you seeing the radical? Okay. And all of you know the formation of molecule and molecular formula. And what is the molecular formula of sodium chloride? NaCl. Okay, understand? And this sodium chloride consists of two parts. One is the sodium ion, which is called also sodium ion, and another part is chlorine minus ion. Two opposite charge ion. So sodium chloride, a molecule consists of two oppositely charged ion. One is sodium ion and chlorine ion. So two opposite part. Okay, and so this part of the radical is nothing, is the part of the compound. And part of the compound, radical is also ion. Radical is ion. It consists of an ion atom or group of atom carrying either a positive or a negative charge. Here I am giving another example that is known as sodium carbonate. What is the formula of sodium carbonate? Na2CO3. And similarly, you see the sodium carbonate is also consists of two parts. One is the Na plus and carbonate CO3 2 minus. And it also consists of two part and two oppositely charged ion. Okay, and one is the sodium plus ion, another is the carbonate CO3 2 minus ion. So these are the part of the compound, and the part of the compound is nothing, is known as the ion, and this ion is also known as the radical. But here in the case of a radical is an ion, maybe an atom. You see, here sodium is a single atom. The radical may be a single atom. Okay. Here radical is a what? The group of atom. Is a group of atom. Behaves like a single entity, single unit in a chemical reaction. Okay. So you can write radical. What is radical? Radical is an atom. Or a group of atom carrying either a negative or a positive charge and behaves like a single unit in a chemical reaction. So, a radical may be ion, a radical is an ion or an atom carrying either a positive or negative charge. Okay, it may be a single atom or a group of atom carrying either a negative or positive charge. Understand or not? And behaves like a single unit in a chemical change or in a chemical reaction. Is it clear? Okay, and here the radical carrying the two types of charge. And one is the positive charge, other is the negative charge. Understand? Okay. So radical carrying on basis of the charge, the radical can be divided into two parts. One is the electropositive radical and other is the electronegative radical. Is it clear? So what is electropositive radical? Let us write. Electropositive radical. Next point you write, second point you write, electropositive radical electropositive radical. So a radical carrying carrying positive charge is called an electropositive radical. Understand? And although electropositive radical, there is another name which is also known as the basic radical. The electropositive radical is also known as basic radical. All the electropositive radical is known as basic radical. Remember, another is also known as basic radical. The electropositive radical is also known as what? Basic radical. Electropositive radicals are also known as what radical? Basic radical. Understand? Okay. All the ions formed from the metals known as the basic radical. Okay. All the metals, ion form, you know the radical is an ion. And what is ion? An ion is formed when a neutral charge carrying either a positive charge or a negative charge. Yes or no? And the ion is known as two types of charge. One is the cation, another is known as anion. What is cation, anion? The cation means known as electropositive radical are known as cation. Okay? Understand? Electropositive are known as cation. All the metals form the cation, electropositive radical. Understand? All the metals form electropositive radical, write down, or basic radical. Electropositive radical or what? Otherwise known as basic radical. Okay, all the metals from the electropositive radical are basic radical. Is it visible all of you? You can say an iron radical is nothing, is an iron. Okay, yes or no? So what is radical? Radical is the other form of ion, you can say also. Yes? Yes or no? And you have all the idea about the ions. So we are talking about the, in the previous class, in the lower class, all of you know, class 9 and 10, about the ions, formation of ions. Okay? And these ions are known, otherwise known as radical. And these are the important part of the compound. Okay? And electropositive radical are that, radical carrying positive charge is called an electropositive radical. And electropositive radical are also known as basic radical. Mostly all the compounds from the electropositive radical are basic radical. Let us see some example of that. Okay, written all of you. So, all of since metals from the electropositive radical, and you know, a radical is nothing, is an ion. And what is an ion? What is an ion? Ion, nothing, is an atom. And ion is formed when a neutral atom gains or loses some electron or accepts some electron also. Okay? And all the metals what lose electron, have tendency to lose electron. All the metals from the positive ions
electropositive radical because they have tendency to lose the what? Lose the electron. You can define also metal also. Metal can be defined. What is metal? An atom which has a tendency to different important definition of metal. Remember. What is that? Metal means what? An atom. Okay, what is an atom? What is the metal? Atom which has a tendency. Tendency to donate or lose electron during a chemical reaction. During a chemical reaction. So when an atom loses the electron, what kind of ions they form? The ions they form is known as cations. Okay. Understand or not? Okay. And all the ions form cation. All the metals form cation. Form cation. Means electropositive radical. Okay, electropositive radical. For example, sodium. Sodium has a tendency according to the electronic configuration atomic number. What is the atomic number of sodium? The atomic number of sodium is 11. So according to electronic configuration, okay, and here the K cell has 2 electrons. K cell has 8 electrons and M cell has 1 electron. So, electronic configuration of sodium is 281. So, according to electronic octet rule, the sodium has a tendency to lose one electron. Has a tendency to lose electron. Yes or no? And here you see in the sodium atom, it is a neutral atom. Atom is neutral. Yes or no? Because it has number of electron is how much? 11. Number of proton is also 11. Yes or no? And when a sodium atom lose one electron, it will happen. So what will happen? You see, the number of electron will be how much? The electronic configuration will be 2, 8. This is the stable electronic configuration, and this is the stable electronic configuration which is nearest to neon, noble gas, which is the most stable element, and do not take part in a chemical reaction. Yes or no? This is why every atom, okay, has a tendency to lose again electron during the process they form the ion. Why do they form the ion? You know, to become stable. The ion is stable than the atom. Okay, because they form electronic octet rule. They have a tendency to attain, maintain 8 electron in their outermost cells. Okay, and after losing one electron, you see the sodium atom and the sodium, you form the formation of sodium positive ion. Why positive ion? Why is the positive ion? You see, here number of electron in the sodium atom is what? 11. Number of proton is 11. And you know electron means what? Carrying negative charge. So 11 unit of negative charge. And sodium atom has 11 unit of positive charge. So number of positive charge and number of negative charge are equal and opposite. So total charge carried by the atom is also 0. So atom is neutral. It does not carry any charge. Atom does not carry any charge. It neither carries negative charge nor carries positive charge. But whenever a sodium atom loses one electron during a chemical reaction, what are you finding? Its electron will be how much? Number of electron will be 10. But proton will be remain same, which is 11. The proton will be remain same. Okay? So it has 11 proton and 10 electron. 11 proton and 10 electron. So you see now, here you see the sodium after losing electron, the sodium atom develop a charge. Why? Because due to difference in their electron and protons. Number of electron and number of proton differs. You see the The sodium, after losing one electron, after donating one electron, the sodium carrying 11 unit of positive charge and 10 unit of negative charge. So it has carried one unit of more unit of positive charge. Number of proton is more than number of electron by one. That's why it carries unit amount of positive charge. That is known as also valency. That is why the sodium valence of sodium is what? What is the valence of sodium is one? What is valency? Number of electron gain or loss? Gain or loss during a chemical reaction by an atom is known as valency. This is the modern definition of valency. All of you know. Yes or no? Okay. So sodium ion is, he forms a sodium ion. Now it is called, because the sodium carrying a positive charge, so this is called an ion or a radical. So an ion is formed when a neutral atom losing one electron. Okay, and it carries what kind of radical? What kind of charge? It carrying positive charge. It carrying positive charge. That is why, okay, and this positive, and it is also known as electropositive radical. Electropositive radical. Understand? Okay, so since sodium is a metal, okay, and it is clear that also all the metals form the positive, what? All the metals carrying positive charge. All the metals forms cation and all the metals are electropositive radical and otherwise known as the basic radical. Is it clear all of you? Similarly, we can say calcium. Calcium atomic number what? Atomic number, what is the calcium atomic number? Denoted by capital J is 20. And here the number of proton how much? 20. And number of electron is also 20. Number of electron is also 20. So, its electronic configuration, what is the electronic configuration is? 2, 8, 8, 2. Yes or no? K cell has 2 electron. L cell has 8 electron. M cell has 8 electron. K, L, M, N cell has 2 electron. And this is the valence cell. Outermost cell of the atom is known as valence cell. And the valence cell has 2 electron. That's why number of electron in the valence cell is also known as valence electron. So, since it carries 2 electrons, and you know, every atom has a tendency to maintain 8 electrons in their outermost cells in order to acquire the octet rule and become stable. This is the natural tendency of every atom. This is the natural tendency. Why do atoms take part in a chemical reaction? This is another reason is there. To maintain 8 electrons in their outermost cells and one of stable electronic configuration. Yes or no? So calcium atom, because 2 electron, it has tendency, it is unstable, atom is unstable. That is why atom is a take part in a chemical reaction. Okay? Understand? So atom take part in a chemical reaction. Why do atom take part in a chemical reaction? The reason is that it becomes stability, to maintain 8 electron in the outermost cells. Those atoms don't have 8 electron in the outermost cells, they take part in a chemical reaction. And those atoms have 8 electrons in the outermost cells, do not take part in a chemical reaction. All the noble gases. Helium except helium is the duplet having 2 electrons. Other noble gases are the 8 electrons in the outermost cells. Helium, neon, argon, krypton, xenon, and radon, all of you know noble gases. And helium has 2 electrons in the outermost cells, and other atom has 8 electrons in the outermost cells. They are all octet. Only helium is the duplet. They are stable. They have a tendency, they neither lose electron nor accept electron. The noble gases, the atoms of noble gases, okay, they will never receive electron from any atom, and also they don't have any tendency to lose the electron. That's why they are the neutral. And all the atoms, they are stable, that's why. Because except noble gases, those atoms do not have 8 electrons in the outermost cell, they have a tendency to lose electron or accept electron in order to become stability during a chemical reaction. That's why atoms take part in a chemical reaction, because of that property. Understand? Here the calcium has 2 electrons in the outermost cells. So calcium being a metal, it has a tendency to lose electron. You can say, sir, he can accept also 6 electron. Calcium atom can accept 6 electron to become octet. But instead of accepting 6 electron, understand or not, the more energy required. So it can easily lose the electron. Understand? So atom will lose 2 electron. How many electrons? 2 electrons to form calcium 2 plus ion. It forms calcium 2 plus ion or calcium radical. And it carries two amount of positive charge. Okay. So what is an ion? Here calcium 2 plus ion is an ion. It is a cation. It is also known as electropositive radical or basic radical. Okay. Why it is carrying two interpositive charge? Because after losing two electron, you see this electronic configuration will be 2, 8 and 8. Which is the stable electron configuration. And this is the nearest to which noble gases? Argon. Argon has this electronic configuration 288. Okay. Understand or not? Okay. So after losing two electron, it attains nearest stable electronic configuration to argon. Noble gases argon, which is stable, which has stable electronic configuration. And there is two interpositive charge. Why? Because by losing electron, you see the number of proton will remain same always. The number of proton of the atom is always same. Because it is the nuclear part, it is found in the nucleus, proton found in the nucleus. Mass of the proton is heavier than the mass of the electron. Okay, the mass of the electron is lighter. Understand? The mass of the proton is heavier. They are found in the nucleus and do not... Okay, and the proton is never, the atom do not lose or accept proton, never. But electron is being lighter, it can easily lost or by gain by some neutral atom. Understand? So by losing electron, its electron will be, after losing electron, it has 20 electron. So after 20 electron, you see 2 electron has been lost. After 2 electron is minus, the remaining number of electron is 18. So electron has 18. The number of electron is 18. It means after losing electron, the electron carrying 18 amount of positive charge and 20 amount of positive charge, 20 unit of positive charge and 18 unit of negative charge. Here the number of protons is more than the number of electron by 2 units. That's why it carries 2 unit of positive charge. Understand? And it is nothing, it is also known as radical. Which radical? Electropositive radical. What is the other name? Basic radical. Why it is basic radical? Because it is a metal. All metals form the basic radical. Electropositive radical. It is very natural, common. Understand all of you? Is it clear about the radical, basic radical? Okay. Let us write some of the more radical about the. So remember some of the radical I am writing. These radicals are. And you see the valency of calcium. How many valency? What is valency? According to definition of valency, I told the number of electron lost or gained by neutral atom is known as valency. So how many electrons is lost by the calcium atom? How many electrons? 2 electrons. That's why its valency is 2. The number of electrons lost by neutral atom is known as valency. This is the definition of valency. Okay. Valency. Understood or not? Okay. And valency take part in a chemical reaction. During a chemical, only electron transfer from one atom to other atom. Electron is transferred from one atom and received by another atom. So, electron are the vital. Which kind of electron? Valence electron. Those electrons found in the outermost energy level of the neutral atom. Only the electron in the valence cell take part in the chemical reaction. Understand? Okay. Because of the, to attain the stability, to attain the inner structure. The ability of atom to maintain 8 electron octet rule. According to octet rule, okay, every atom tends to become stable. Okay, so okay, understood regarding the basic radical. Let us some more example of basic radical I am discussing here. So also from basic radical, you understand the concept of valency also. Okay, and number of unit of charge carrying by radical is known as valency. Okay. Let us see here, and you see, what is that? You see the sodium atom, the valence of electropositive radical, write down electropositive, example of electropositive radical. Electropositive radical. एग्जांपल ऑफ इलेक्ट्रोपॉजिटिव रेडिकल और बेसिक रेडिकल। अनदर कंसेप्ट आई वुड लाइक टू से, एन इफ रेडिकल कंसिस्ट ऑफ सिंगल एटम इट इज कॉल्ड सिंपल रेडिकल। व्हाट इज रेडिकल? सिंपल रेडिकल। अनदर पॉइंट लेट मी रिमाइंड यू, सिंपल रेडिकल, व्हाट इज सिंपल रेडिकल? What is simple radical? Simple radical what? A radical consists of single atom or ion. It's called simple radical. It's called simple radical. Yes or no? For example, sodium ion is a simple radical because it consists of one atom. Again, you can say the calcium ion, two electron positive charge, it is a simple radical because why? It consists of single atom. Understand or not? Okay, chlorine ion, I'm not talking about it radical, maybe the simple radical may be carry positive charge or negative charge, it does not matter, but it consists of what? Single atom, because it's a single atom. Okay, similarly fluorine, it is a simple radical, yes or no? Oxygen is a simple radical. Nitrogen is a simple radical. So these are all simple radical because these are consist of single atom. They may carry positive charge or negative charge. Understand or not? Okay. Magnesium is a simple radical carrying two unit of positive charge. Here, cupros is a simple radical. Cupros, LH1. Cupric is a simple radical. Yes or no? Understand? Then ferrous, LNC2 is a simple radical. Yes or no? The ferric is a simple radical. Understand? Yes or no? Arous, what is the valence of arous? What is the valence of arous? Gold. What is the valence of gold? Yes. Arous, don't know, simple radical, one positive unit charge. Auric, simple radical, two ion, yes or no? Yes or no? Then, after that, yes, plumbos is a simple radical, and plumbic is a simple radical. Radical means what? Simple radical, it must be single atom. Okay. Understand? Stannous, valence is 2, is a simple radical. Understand? One by one we're writing. Then stannic is a simple radical. So these are the example of simple radical. The simple
electronegative radicals. Yes, today I am discussing over the concept of electronegative radicals. Okay, are you ready, all of you? And all of you have the basic idea about the electropositive radical. In the previous class we have discussed here. Okay, and I am going to discuss electronegative radicals. Okay, and all of you know what is electropositive radicals. The radicals carrying which charge? Positive charge are called electropositive radical. The radicals or ions carrying positive charge are called electropositive radicals. One or more unit of positive charge, it may be one unit or may be more than one unit, okay, are called electropositive radicals. Here I am discussing electronegative radical. This is the basic concept of the language of chemistry. Okay, foundation of the chemistry. Radicals are the very much important for the formation of molecular formula. So let us see. So what is electronegative radicals? And these electronegative radicals, otherwise known as acidic radical. Which radicals? Acidic radicals. Okay. Shall we discuss? Okay. Let's see. So what are electronegative radicals? Is that number one? Electronegative radicals. Electronegative radicals. Electronegative radicals. What are they? These are also part of the, all of you know, the compound consists of two part. One is the electropositive part, electropositive radical. Another is the electronegative radical or basic radical. Another one, acidic radical. Okay, understand? And all the radicals are also known as ions. Radicals otherwise known as ions. Okay, let's see. Electronegative radical means the ions are the radicals. The radicals are ions carrying positive charge. Carrying positive charge. Carrying which charge? Positive or negative charge? Negative charge, not positive charge. Negative charge. Okay. Carrying negative charge. The radicals carrying negative charge are called electronegative radicals. Electronegative radicals. These electronegative radicals are also known as acidic radical. Okay, these are also known as acidic radical. Okay, these radicals are also known as which radical? Acidic radical. Acidic radicals. Understand? And all the negative ions, means anions, okay, are acidic radicals. Okay? And all the negative ions, means anions, are electronegative radicals. Are electronegative radicals or acidic radicals? Yes or no? Carrying which charge? Negative charge. Okay, negative ions are known as also anions. Okay, and all the nonmetals, all the nonmetals form which radical? Acidic radical. Acidic radicals. Understand? Okay. Understand? So these are also important, another part of the compound. A compound consists of two part. One is the electropositive radical, another is the electronegative radicals. Right? Okay.
Now let's see. Okay, a radical carrying unit amount of electronegative radical carrying unit amount of negative charge are called monovalent radical, and its valence is 1. Its valence is 1, and you know the valence is take part important part in chemical reaction. Yes or no? So a radical carrying unit amount of negative charge okay it's called a monovalent electronegative radical monovalent electronegative radicals. Okay, and all the monovalent electronegative radical having valency 1. Okay, for example, I can say you. Monovalent electronegative radical, I can say you hydroxyl ion, for example, monovalent electronegative radical. Let us discuss some example of monovalent electronegative radical. Okay, note on this one. Let us discuss the example of monovalent electronegative radical. Okay. First of all, you have to discuss the basic monovalent, basic radical, simple radical. Monovalent, simple radical. Electronegative simple radical means what? The radical having one kind of elements are called, it's called a simple radical. And the radical consists of different kind of element, group of atoms having different kind of element. It's called what? Compound radicals. Okay. Let us see the monovalent electronegative radical, simple radical. Okay. Understand? Okay, next point I am discussing example of monovalent electronegative simple radical. Simple radical means what? One kind of atoms. Okay, the radical having same kind of elements. Monovalent simple radical, electronegative, monovalent electronegative simple radical. For example, I can say chloride, the compound of hydrogen chloride. Okay, what is the Cl minus? Remember this, Cl minus, minus means, and it carries, the valence is 1, and it is carries unit amount of negative charge. Okay, second one, halogen group fluoride. The fluoride is F minus fluoride. Third one, bromide. That is Br minus. Okay. And another one, iodide. What is that? I minus. Okay, and next one is that these are known as hydride is minus, right? And second one, next one was oxide O2 minus. Understand? Nitrite. So these are the some example of monovalent electronegative simple radical. Understand or not? Is it clear to all of you? These are all simple radical because this consists of what? same kind of element. Okay, understand? Okay, so then let us consider monovalent, electronegative. These are the simple radical. Next, compound radical. Compound radical, the group of radical consists of group of atoms of different elements. Are called monovalent, electronegative, compound radicals. Right? Let's see. Okay. Next point you have to discuss that point 8. Monovalent, electronegative, compound radicals. Compound radical. Compound radicals. Okay. Understand? Is it clear? Let's see one example. Number one is hydroxide. Valency one. These are monovalent. Means valency one. Monovalent means what? Valency one. Okay. So first of all, hydroxide. Hydroxide what? OH minus consists of oxygen and hydrogen, two different kind of elements and carrying unit amount of negative charge. Balance is 1 here. Okay. Minus means is the valence is 1. 2 minus means valence is 2. Right? Understand? Because of the single minus sign is there. Second one is the hydrogen carbonate or bicarbonate. Bicarbonate is CO3 minus, you see, it consists of one atom of hydrogen, one atom of carbon and three atom of oxygen. This is a, it is also known as hydrogen carbonate. It is also known as hydrogen carbonate. Hydrogen carbonate. So this is an example of compound radical. Right? Understand? Third, next point. Acetate, what is that? CH3COO minus. You see, this is a another example of monovalent, electronegative, compound radical. Okay, understand? Okay, next point you write. Next you say, next point you write out bicarbonate over bisulfate. Bisulfate is SO4 minus. Bisulfate or hydrogen sulfate. Bisulfate is SO4 minus bisulfate. Okay, this is a compound radical. Then another one, bisulfite. HSO3 minus bisulfite HSO3 minus. Okay, minus. So difference between the bisulfate and bisulfite, it has one more oxygen atom in bisulfate. Okay, you see one hydrogen atom here, one hydrogen atom. It consists of one sulfur atom, one sulfur atom. Here is four oxygen atom, here three oxygen atom. Differ by one oxygen atom. Okay, understand? Is also known as hydrogen sulfide. Is also known as hydrogen sulfide. Its other name also hydrogen. Hydrogen what? Sulfide. Is it clear? Hydrogen sulfide. Okay. Next point, you know. Okay, and is it clear? Understand? Okay, let us write some more. Okay, all of you know. What do you know? Chloride. Chloride, you know. Monovalent radical. Chloride. See. Chloride. What? Cl minus it is a what? You know basic radical, but I will tell you hypochlorite. Hypochlorite. Next point is hypochlorite. It is a monovalent hypochlorite. R-I-T-E. Spelling is very important. Dihypochloride is there, ClO minus, ClO minus. Okay, and after hypochlorite, you known as hypobromite. Similarly, hypobromite. Hypobromite. Spelling is T. BRO minus. Okay. Then next part is hypoiodite. Hypoiodide will be iodine and oxygen. Unit amount of negative charge. It is a compound radical. Okay. Then after that you chloride. Chloride is there. C-A-C-L-O-R-I-T-E. Hello. The chloride formula is that ClO2 minus. ClO2 minus. So spelling is most important. You see, R-I-D-E. D is that Cl minus. If T-E, it will be ClO2 minus. It's quite different. And it is an example of acid radical and it is an example of compound radical. It consists of only chlorine atoms. It consists of chlorine and oxygen atom. Okay. Understand? One chlorine atom and two oxygen atom. This radical is consist of one chlorine atom and two oxygen atom. Is or no? So this is the chloride spelling. Understand? Similarly, iodide. Iodide. TE. So it will be IO2 minus. Understand? Okay. Is it clear? Okay. Then after that, another point is there also chloride. You see, so many compounds are there on the chlorine. Chloride. All are looking same, but they are different composition. Composition are different. ClO3 minus. ClO3 minus. You see, chloride is Cl minus. Chloride is ClO2 minus. Okay, hypochloride is ClO minus. Chloride is what? ClO3 minus. Okay, here it consists of one atom of chlorine and three atom of oxygen. Okay. And carrying unit amount of negative charge. So, it is a monovalent electronegative compound radicals, right? Okay. Understand? Then after that, perchlorate. Perchlorate. The formula is ClO4 minus perchlorate. Perchlorate. So, are you finding so many radicals over the chlorine? Perchlorate. ClO4. ClO4 minus. One atom of chlorine and four atom of oxygen. Radical consists of one atom of chlorine and four atom of oxygen. Okay. Similarly, you will say perchlorate, perbromate. What is perbromate? Br similarly O4 minus. Yes or no? Understand perbromate. These are all examples of monovalent radical, right? Similarly, poriodate, you can write also. Poriodate. So, this radical very much important in framing the molecular formula. If you don't know radicals, you cannot make molecular formula. IO4. Iodine, one atom of iodine and four atom of oxygen and carrying unit amount of negative charge. So, because it consists of, this radical consists of different kind of atoms, and carrying unit of negative charge, so this is an example of, these are all example of monovalent electronegative radical. Okay, understand? Is it clear? Okay, so next point 16 you see. Next point you write nitrate. What is nitrate? NO3 minus nitrate. Right. Okay. And next point is that nitrite. Nitrite. What is the different formula? NO2 minus. Okay. Differ by one oxygen atom. Nitrite and nitrate. Differ by one oxygen atom. Right. Okay. Then next formula is that hypophosphite. H2PO3 minus hypophosphite. Hypophosphite. PHITE. Hypophosphite. H2PO3 minus. Okay, this is hypophosphite. Also known as dihydrogen phosphite. Because two consist of two hydrogen atom is also known as dihydrogen. Its other name is also dihydrogen phosphate. Understand? So these are the naming you must remember. Naming must be remembered. Otherwise, you cannot make a compound, you can name a compound also. So the molecular formula is given and you have to name the what is the name of that compound. If you don't know radicals, then very difficult to give the name of that compound. Very difficult to give the name of that molecule, right? Understand or not? Okay. Is it clear? Then cyanide. Another important formula is cyanide. Cyanide. What is that? Cn minus carbon and nitrogen. Consist of carbon and nitrogen. Then cyanate. Cyanate, C-Y-A-N-A-T-E. This is called cyanide. You can say cyanide also. Cn minus. This is called cyanate. Okay. And this is, the formula is Cn1D4 by oxygen atom. Cyanide. Cn minus. Cyanate, CNO minus. Okay. Next, another is the thiocyanate. Whose formula is HCl minus. Thiocyanate. Understand? Thiocyanate. And it's HCN minus. Thiocyanate. Okay. Understand? Then write permanganate. Permanganate formula what? MnO4. Potassium permanganate. KMnO4. Okay. So permanganate is MnO4. Okay. Understand? And you know oxide. Oxide what? Is it divalent? But superoxide. So superoxide is what? O2, 2 minus. So oxide is at O minus, differ by, you see, the oxide is there, oxide, what is the difference in that? O, 2 minus, consists of one atom of oxygen, and superoxide, find the difference, and it will be what? O2, 2 minus, right? Understand, superoxide valency 1. Sorry, valency 1. Okay, difference only one valency. Valency 1. Understand? It consists, oxide consists of one atom of oxygen. Superoxide consists of two atoms of oxygen. And it's carrying two units of negative charge. And superoxide carrying one unit of negative charge. This is the difference. Okay? And this is a, that's why this is a monovalent radical and this is a divalent radical. Right? We shall discuss example of divalent radicals. Okay? Clear, students? Okay. Let's see. These are the example of monovalent radical. Let us remember this. Next, we shall move divalent electronegative compound radical. Right? Divalent. What is the divalent radical? Let's see. Divalent radical, student. Divalent electronegative compound radicals. You see. Okay, divalent radicals. Okay, let's see. This is the next point we are discussing. Divalent electronegative radicals. Electronegative or divalent acid radicals. Negative radicals. Understand or not? Is it clear? Okay, let's some example of divalent radicals. First, to write down carbonate. Number one, carbonate. ओके CO3 2 माइनस एंड बाइकार्बोनेट व्हाट व्हाट इज बाइकार्बोनेट व्हाट इज बाइकार्बोनेट तो बाइकार्बोनेट व्हाट इज बाइकार्बोनेट नोट लेट अस फाइंड द डिफरेंस बाइकार्बोनेट बाइकार्बोनेट दैट इज CO3 माइनस एंड कार्बोनेट इज दैट CO3 2 माइनस So it is a monovalent compound radical, it is a divalent compound radical, its valence is 1 and its valence is 2. And it consists of one hydrogen atom, one carbon atom and 3 oxygen atom. And it consists of one carbon atom and 3 oxygen atom. Here hydrogen is absent here in the carbonate. Clear? Understand? Okay? Okay, next one. Next point you write. Carbonate up to radon chromate. Chromate. Potassium chromate, okay. Understand sodium chromate, Cr(O4)2-. This is the chromate, okay. Then dichromate, dichromate. What is dichromate? Cr(2)O7)2-. See the difference. See the difference. Okay. It consists of one atom of chromium. Consists of two atom of chromium. And if this radical consists of 4 atom of oxygen, it consists of 7 atom of oxygen. There is a huge difference. But if both are, the valence is M. But names are different. Okay. So we shall get the another radicals. That is known as, we can make the another formula, another composition, another compound using the chromate and dichromate. Potassium chromate and potassium dichromate. They are entirely different. Okay. Understand? Then next point you write manganate. Manganate. Or manganate what? Manganate Mn. Sorry, MnO4(2-). Or manganate what? MnO4-. Or manganate, you know. So, different in the valence only. Yes or no? Or manganate. You see the or manganate difference. Or manganate. Or manganate. What is that? MnO4-. See the difference. Only the difference in valency. It is divalent and that is per magnet is monovalent. It is monovalent radical. Difference the valency, right? Understand? Then you write sulfite. PHIDE. Okay, sulfite. S(2-). Consists of it is a basic radical because it consists of only one kind of atoms. Okay. And second one is the sulfite, S-U-L-P-H-I-T-E, sulfite, and this formula is SO3, 2-, sulfite, okay, this is the difference in the sulfite and, okay, then next point you write sulfate, SO4, 2-, sulfate, sulfate, sulfate SO4, 2-. Okay, next point is that after sulfate, and you have to write thiosulfate is that, and that S2O3. 2-, thiosulfate, S2O3, 2-, right? Understand? Okay, another one, tetrathionate, another is a tetrathionate, its formula is that S4O6, S4, 4 atom of sulfur, O6, 6 atom oxygen and valence is 2, divalent. Okay, tetrathionate, S4O6, 2-, right? Understand? Okay, per disulfate, another is interesting that per disulfate. See, the new name is coming. Okay, understand? Per disulfate, its formula is that S2O8. The S2 OH, 2 minus. Here the 2 atom of sulfur and 8 atom of oxygen, we shall get four disulfate. Okay, understand? Okay, so note down this one. Okay, so I hope you will remember this one, you will practice this one. Okay, and practice, try to remember the radicals and their formula. Then you are able to make the molecular formula. You can frame chemical equation and their valency, and you can also develop the chemical reaction also. And chemistry is the related with the language of chemistry. So this is the very important when you are discussing. Okay, so these radicals are divalent electronegative radicals. Okay, so these are. Shall we discuss some more example is there? Let's discuss. Okay. Another one you known as. Yes. Okay. And you know the example of oxide. Oxide. What is the number I will give? Okay, I am studying another number. Okay. Oxide. You give the serial number here. And you know oxide O2. Oxide O2 minus. And second one is what? Peroxide. What is peroxide? O2 2 minus. Difference is that. Okay. Understand or not? And superoxide. Another one, superoxide. See, find the difference. Find the difference, students. This is O2 minus. Understand or not? So superoxide valency 2. It consists of and oxide valency 2 and peroxide valency 2. The difference is that it consists of 2 atom of peroxide, 2 atom of oxygen, oxide 1 atom of oxygen, superoxide 1 atom of oxygen. Right? Okay. Then write stannite. Next is stannite. Stannite. What is the formula of stannite? SnO2. SnO2 2 minus. Valence is 2. Okay. Then stannite. After stannite, you write of stannate. SnO3. Stannate. Okay. Here another word. Stannate is that SnAIT. Double I. Double T. And here stannate. Double N. STA. Double N. ATE. Pronunciation. Sorry. Oh, SnO3. 2 minus. Right. Then next is that silicate. What is silicate? SiO3 2 minus. Okay. Then another one, oxalate. You get C2O4. C2O4 2 minus. C2O4 2 minus. No need to give this. 2 minus. Or you can write COO 4 to 2 minus. Right. We can write also in this manner. Okay. Understand? Then you write plumbite. EbO2 2 minus. Plumbite. EbO2 2 minus plumbite. Right? Understand? Then plumbate. Plumbate is there. PbO3 2 minus plumbate. Right? Okay? Understand? This is another one interesting radical is that pyroantimonate. The formula is that H2PP2O7 2 minus. Is it divalent? H2PP2O7 2 minus. This is called pyroantimonate. Okay. Understand? Note down. no doubt. Next, 11 point. Next 11 point you write. What is that? You see, it is given tetraborate. Tetraborate. Tetraborate, the formula is that B4, 4 atom of boron and O7, 7 atom of oxygen and 2 minus, balance is 2, right? Okay. Then after that you write monohydrogen phosphate. It is formula like that, monohydrogen phosphate or HPO3. This is HPO3 2 minus hydrogen phosphate, right? Understand? And another point you can write that, okay, hydrophosphate. Hydrophosphate, the formula is that HPO4, 2 minus, not PO3, PO4. Okay. And another is that, next one is that zincate is that ZnO2. Zincate formula ZnO2, 2 minus. Okay. Next point. Okay, tungstate. See, you are getting new name. Is that tungstate? Tungsten W Ultram. Its chemical name is WO4 2 minus. Tungstate. Okay, another interesting radical, tungstate. WO4 2 minus. Okay, titanate. Titanate. What is titanate? Titanium and O3 2 minus. Titanate. Okay. And fluorosilicate. Another is fluorosilicate. Fluorosilicate. FLEO. Fluoro. FLEO. SILICATE. Fluorosilicate. Its formula is SIF6. SIF6 2 minus. These are the example of divalent radical. So, okay. Understand? So, these are valency 1. All these compounds are valency. Divalent means valency what? 2. Okay. Understand? Okay. Next, shall we discuss trivalent radical. Trivalent means the valency. Electronic radical valency 3 and tetravalence radical. Okay, let's have an example of trivalent radical. Which radical? Trivalent electronegative radical. Point 1 is right. Trivalent radical. First, Almonate. ALUMINATE, almonate, and its chemical formula is ALO3, 2 minus almonate. And second one is that arsenite, ASO3. ASO3 2 minus. 3 minus, sorry, valence is 3, we are talking about the trivalent, and it is a trivalent, valency, trivalent electronegative radicals, ALO3, 3 minus, and all of the valency 3, okay, the radicals carrying 3 units of negative charge are called trivalent, what, electronegative radicals, yes or no, okay, then you see arsenate, third point you write arsenate, ACNATE. Arsenate, its chemical formula is ASO4. ASO4, 3 minus. Okay. Next point is known as after arsenate, write down arsenite. 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 Arsenide that only AS3 minus. This is a simple radical. Okay, this is a simple radical, example of simple radical, which consists of only one kind of atoms. Okay, then borite. BORIDE, borite. The compound of boron and it's B3 minus. Okay, a simple radical because it consists of same kind of atom. Then borate. Borate formula is that BO3 minus borate. Understand? Nitrite. Nitrite. Already I have discussed. It is a trivalent simple radical N3 minus. Okay. Nitrite. Then phosphite. D phosphite. The formula is that P3 minus. P3 minus, this is nitrogen. So these are all the example of trivalent electronegative radicals. Okay, understand? Let's discuss few more. And another one is that phosphite. After phosphite, PHITE, and its formula is that PO3, PO3 3 minus. PO3 3 minus, right? Then after that you write, after phosphite write down phosphate. 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 PO4 3 minus. PO4 3 minus. These are the example of trivalent electronegative radical. Let us write some more interesting radicals. Okay, let's discuss this class for you. And you will complete, you will understand the different types of radicals. It's a very good class for you. And a very important basic structure, basic foundation of the language of chemistry. Understand, this is known as the ABCD of chemistry. And if you don't know the radicals, then you cannot proceed. You can do nothing with the chemistry. Chemistry is a problem to you always. So, the next point, right? Trivalent radical, next point you write what? Ferricyanite. Ferricyanite. Okay, the formula is that Fe CN whole 6. Valence is what? 3. Ferricyanite. Okay, understand? Then another interesting formula is oxychloride. And valence is 3. Okay. OCl. OCl 3 minus. Oxychloride. This is oxychloride. Right. Understand? And another one is that oxybromide. Similarly, oxybromide. Similar manner. What? O, B, R, bromine and 3 minus trivalent radical. Understand? Oxybromide. After that, oxyiodide. Oxyiodide. Okay, oxygen and iodine will be there and valence will be 3 internal negative charge, electronegative radical. So, these are example of trivalent electronegative radical. Let's discuss the example of tetravalent electronegative radicals. What are tetravalent electronegative radical students? The radical carrying 4 units of negative charge. Okay. And it carrying 4 units of negative charge. Tetravalence electronegative radical. Tetravalence electronegative radical. Let me discuss some example. And you will, this will help you in next class. And you students will try to frame the molecular formula. Okay. Tetravalent. Let us see tetravalent. Tetravalent electro negative radicals. Okay, tetravalence electro negative radicals. The radicals having valency 4. Okay, the valency must be 4. What is the valency? The valency must be 4. It carry 4 unit of negative charge. Number 1, first point. Okay, you write ferrocyanide. Ferrocyanide. Ferrocyanide, you studied ferrocyanide. Ferrocyanide. Okay. And the formula is that Fe CN 4 6, valence is what? 4 minus. And you know ferrocyanide? Ferrocyanide in the. What is that? What is that? Fe CN 4 6, what? Valency 3? Difference in the valency. So valency 3, it is ferrocyanide. Valency 4 is ferrocyanide. Okay? Understand? Then after that you see pyrophosphate. Next point you write pyrophosphate. Pyrophosphate. What is pyrophosphate? P2O7, 4 minus. 4 minus, valence is 4. P2. 2 atom of phosphorus and 7 atom of oxygen. Okay? Understand? Then, okay, carbide what? C4 minus carbide. Understand? And another one is that also pyroarsenate ARSENATE. Its formula is that AS2O7 4 minus. Okay, pyroarsenate. And next formula is that pyroantimonate. Okay, similar formula Sb2 stibium, Sb2 and O7 4 minus pyroantimonate. Okay, so this is all our example of tetravalent electronegative radical. So students, all of you, I hope. And another one is trisilicate also. Trisilicate I have not written, let us write. Trisilicate, the S will be small letter. Trisilicate, understand? Its formula is Si3. Si3O8 4 minus. Si3O8 4 minus. Understand? Okay. And ferrothiocyanate. Another is ferrothiocyanate. Another example is that ferrothiocyanate. Understand? And its chemical formula is Fe whole CN. Okay, CNS whole 6 4 minus. Okay, then another interesting formula is that FeCN S whole 6. So, these are the examples of the different types of examples of the electronegative radicals. So, students, these are very much important to learn. These are the foundation of the chemistry. If you don't know the radicals, then it is very difficult to frame the molecular formula. Okay. And next class, thank you for watching this class and for your interest in the class. Okay. And for your patience, I hope. And you will practice this and remember the different examples of radicals, electropositive and electronegative radicals. And by that you are able to make the formation of a molecular formula. How to make the molecular formula. And next class we shall discuss. Okay. Keep on watching and keep on practicing.
So chemistry foundation course I am going to start. I hope you will enjoy. Thank you.